The next topic we are going to see is about the induction of EMF by changing the orientation. Already we have seen with the induction of EMF by changing the magnetic field and the area, is it not? So this is a very important one. This is by changing the relative orientation. As I told you already, what it is meant by orientation is, orientation is nothing but the angle. Okay, so when we change with the angle, so what is the change in the EMF? Okay, so when you see that, that is said to be the induction of EMF by changing the orientation. Okay, for this let us consider a rectangular coil, and this rectangular coil has a N turns and it has a magnetic field B, and this coil is being rotated in the anti-clockwise direction with angular velocity omega. Okay, so let us consider the rectangular coil. This is a rectangular coil which we are considering, and this coil we are going to rotate it in the anti-clockwise direction. So when you are just rotating in the anti-clockwise direction, what happens to the induced EMF? Okay, so that is what we are going to see here. Yes, let us consider this to be the coil, and this coil is being rotated in the anti-clockwise direction. So when you are rotating, it makes the angle theta. Okay, so it makes the angle theta, and that theta is given by omega t. Okay, so theta is equal to omega t, and this phi, okay, that is also equal to phi m into cos omega t, because this phi is being split into two components here, but we are going to take only with phi m into cos theta. Okay, so when you write the value here, at time t is equal to 0, the plane of the coil is perpendicular and the flux linked is maximum when phi of m is equal to b into a. B is a magnetic field and a is a area of the coil. Next is phi n into phi of b. Instead of this phi of b, we are writing as phi m into cos theta. Okay, phi m into cos theta. So this is n into phi b. When you have to get the value of e, e is equal to what? Minus d by dt of this n phi b. Now instead of this n phi b, we are writing as n phi m into cos theta. Now bring this n outside and also phi m outside, so we get d by dt of cos omega t. Okay, so what is the differentiation of cos omega is, so cos omega, first we bring omega outside, so it is omega into minus sin omega t. Okay, so already we have the minus sign here, so we are writing the minus as it is in this, and the differentiation of cos omega t, we get minus sin omega t into this omega. So we are writing this as minus into minus, that becomes as plus. So n phi m into omega into sin omega t. Okay, so this gives the value of this EMF. Okay, so clear with this? Clear with how to differentiate with the value of cos omega t in this? So differentiation of cos omega t, it is omega into sin omega t. Considering the value of sin omega t is equal to 1, okay, we get em is equal to n phi m into omega, because sin omega t we are writing it as 1. Okay, now instead of this phi m, it can also be written as what? B into a. So n as it is, instead of this phi into m, we are writing it as ba into omega. So phi is equal to n a b into omega. So this gives a maximum value of the EMF when changing the orientation of the coil. Okay, so e is equal to em into sin omega t, because instead of this n a b omega, okay, so this n a b omega can be written as what? Em. And so in this equation, substitute this phi m is equal to b into a, so we'll be getting the equation as phi is equal to n into n as it is. Okay, so we are getting the equation as n into phi m, we are writing it as b into a into omega as it is, and also this sin omega t as it is. Okay, so what is this n a b into omega? Is this n a b omega can be written as what? E of m. Okay, so we are writing this as e is equal to, this can be written as em, so em into sin into omega t. T. Okay, so that is the equation for the EMF which we are getting. Okay, so only we are writing this equation as E is equal to EM into sin omega T. Same way when you are writing it for I, that I can be written as I is equal to IM into sin omega T, where IM is a maximum value of induced current. Clear? So this is represented with the help of the diagram here. So this is a coil, okay, and this coil we are rotating in the anti-clockwise direction. At first omega T we are considering it as 0, next omega T is equal to pi by 2, then omega T is equal to pi, this is 3 pi by 2 and 2 pi. Clear with the value of omega T? First it is 0, then it is pi by 2, next it is pi and 3 pi by 2 and also 2 pi. Okay, so as we are rotating this coil, first it is in the slanting way, next it becomes straight, again it becomes in the slanting way, then again in the same position as this. Okay, so we have to be make clear with the value of omega T. So omega T 0, pi by 2, pi, 3 pi by 2 and 2 pi. Okay, now this is how the position of coil is. First it is in the slanting position, then it is kept straight, then again slanting, straight and slanting. Okay, first omega T value is equal to 0, next it is pi by 2, then pi, next 3 pi by 2 and 2 pi. So when it is equal to 0, we can write the value as E is equal to EM into sin omega T. Omega T value is what? 0. What is the value of sin 0 is? Is 0. Okay, so E is equal to 0. Okay, first let us see with all these values. Okay, based on this. Yes, now the next is E is equal to EM into sin omega T. Omega T is value is what? Pi by 2. So sin pi by 2 is what? 1. So we are getting E is equal to EM. Next, then E is equal to EM into sin pi. Okay, sin pi. Sin values, if you see, 0, pi, 2 pi, all these values are equal to 0. So we'll be getting the value as 0. Next is 3 pi by 2. 3 pi by 2, it is minus 1. Okay, pi by 2, it is plus 1. Okay, and 3 pi by 2, it is minus 1. So we are getting the value as minus E into M. Okay, so corresponding to this, when you draw the graph, okay, so we'll be getting the graph as, first see the value of E. Okay, first one is E value is 0. Okay, so it is 0. Okay, next is E value is equal to EM, so it is a maximum value, so it is EM. Okay, next is E value is 0, again 0. Okay, so it is 0, pi by 2, pi, these are all over. Next is 3 pi by 2. For the value of 3 pi by 2, E is equal to what? Minus EM. So we are bringing this in the negative direction, so it is minus EM. Then again 0. So we are bringing this as 0 in the value of 2 pi. Okay, so clear? So when you join with all these points, we'll be getting the graph like this. Okay, mention the points is EM and this point to be minus EM, and this axis is E and this axis we are writing as omega T. Okay, so this diagram is very important. So draw this, write the value and draw the graph. Okay, so that it will be easy for you. Okay, so this gives your induced EMF by changing the orientation of the coil. Clear? Thank you.